Meanwhile, in Brazil, and this one very much goes out to Francesca, Lula's back and gonna be running against Bolsonaro. Lula previously served as Brazil's president from 2003 to 2010, left office with an 83% approval rating. That is pretty amazing, Francesca. I assumed that you would be excited about this news. What do you think about this clash of titans?
Well, I lived in Argentina, so you got that one wrong. I'm not sure why, but yes, neighboring Brazil.
I think you would have lived there. I think that you would be invested in the political outcomes of a noted successful leftist candidate going up against a fascist.
Okay.
I know that there are different countries in the world.
No, but people think South America and they think Brazil. I'm glad he is back in the race. It does seem like he's the only one who can really challenge someone like Bolsonaro in terms of the name recognition, in terms of popularity, in terms of people being like, oh, guess we shouldn't have like kicked you out and like locked you up in jail. Sorry. But at the same time, I think I am very wary because I think Lula needs a successor fast. And I think it is only a matter of time before the country turns on him yet again. And so I wish it were someone else from the Workers' Party and not Lula himself. But again, I understand that like name recognition goes far. And you know, just like in this country, people are like, well, who could actually take on Trump? It's gotta be Biden. Like Biden doesn't know where he is right now.
Well, in any event, we have a little bit of a parallel, not only in needing the popular leftist to find a successor and fast, but also Bolsonaro apparently is going to be seeking an audit of the country's electronic voting system ahead of the elections in October. He's spent months questioning the validity of the country's voting systems. That's fun. Hey, the big lie, so big now that it can take over more than one country. Isn't that fun? And meanwhile, in Afghanistan, when the Taliban took over the country again like half a year ago, they swore it's not gonna be the same Taliban of more than a decade or two decades prior. This is gonna be a new Taliban. But no, they are now saying that Muslim women must cover from head to toe in public. Saying though, this is not a restriction on women, but an order of the Quran. It's an order of Allah and the Prophet Muhammad. Women may choose to wear the head to toe covering called a burqa or a cloth veil covering the face paired with a headscarf and a long robe called an abaya. So they're back to that, which is fun. And it's nice to see, you know, in multiple countries, Francesca, women's rights being stripped away. It just feels like a throwback to an earlier time. And you know, in fact, hate to see it happening.
Cue mission accomplished banner behind me. Yay. Man, this is amazing. This is why we went into Afghanistan, right? Freeing the women so we don't have to see them in a burqa, because that looks strange to me. It's just, of course, this was going to happen. It is really disheartening. I think we need to find the US leftists and progressives need to find, and there are organizations on the ground to support, especially women's organizations in Afghanistan. And I'm honestly waiting for a Republican to campaign on reinvading Afghanistan in the next 4 to 6 years. It'll happen.
We'll see. But yeah, and it's just devastating. Like to have had this period of some relative freedoms, more economic opportunity and all that, and then to have it stripped away. Like you can read a lot of statements of people like they're like this woman, Benazir Bhattacharya, a television presenter, saying we've lost our way. They could be fixing real problems, but instead they're focusing on this. And my heart goes out to them. Like it's obviously a different scale, but that is what we're seeing from our, you know, right-wing party here. No acknowledgement of actual economic problems, no solutions. Instead, just this sort of religious dogma-based culture war stuff. So terrible that that's going on. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.